The James Webb Space Telescope is going to be the premier infrared observatory of our age, probably because it's going to be the only infrared observatory of our age, at least when it comes to being space-based. It's going to be huge. And this has been always one of the challenges of space telescopes. Like, why don't we just send every telescope into space, away from the atmosphere, away from the Earth, where it's nice and pristine and perfect stargazing conditions. One of the challenges is that rockets are only so wide. Like, you know, they're like yay big. Probably a tiny bit bigger than this, but you get the idea. So you can't put a mirror. You want a big mirror for astronomy to collect a lot of light. Astronomers love mirrors. The bigger, the better. You can't put a mirror wider than the telescope or wider than the rocket on top of the rocket. You can't like go like this and it launch. That just doesn't work. Trust me. But James Webb is going to have a mirror 6.5 meters across. That's 21 feet across. That is a little bit wider than rockets. And in order to make this work, it's not just one big giant mirror, a big solid piece of glass that's going to be duct taped to the side of a rocket. It's going to be segmented. There's something like 18 hexagonal segments that make up the mirror, and they're all going to be folded together and packed inside the top of the rocket so it all fits. Also folded up will be its sun shield, this giant 22 meter by 10 meter. Again, that's, you know, larger than a rocket. That's going to be folded up too. So it's this nice little package inside the rocket. It'll get to space, go a million miles away, and then unfold. It will unfold its sun shield. It will unfold its mirror, and it will start doing all of its science. That's yet another reason why James Webb is so expensive and so delayed, because this is a very complicated thing. Like, literally unfolding a telescope in space. All right, and there's no IKEA instructions, there's no user manual, there's no wrenches, like it just has to do it all on its own a million miles away from Earth, and we only get one shot. If something doesn't unfold right, we're done. Hopefully it goes up. It's scheduled for March of 2021. Don't hold your breath. If it goes up in time, if it unfolds right and starts doing science, it's going to do some amazing science. It's going to be an infrared telescope, so it will take pictures. There's three cameras on board for different bands of wavelengths of the infrared part of the electromagnetic spectrum. It is going to take pictures, but not as the human eye can see it. We will get some pretty pictures to ooh and ah over, but they're going to be mapped. Like, okay, this wavelength of infrared is we're going to call green. This wavelength we're going to call dark green. This wavelength we're going to call yellow. This one we're going to call blue, et cetera, et cetera. So we'll get some pretty pictures, but they're not going to be anywhere close to what you can see with the eyeball. The James Webb Space Telescope is obsessed with infrared. It is designed to be an infrared telescope because that's where a lot of very juicy science is that we can't access from the ground. One of the biggest things it's going to study is the early universe, and it's going to study some of the first galaxies to ever appear in the universe when our universe was just 500 million years old. Now, the galaxies born when the 13 billion years ago, when our universe was just 500 million years old, are just stars, galaxies, dust. Like, you know, if you were to be transported back there and look at it, you'd say, oh, yeah, it's a galaxy. It's pumping out tons of visible light. Galaxies are very, very bright and visible light because they're made of stars, and stars are bright and invisible in optical wavelengths. And so are galaxies. Like, you can even literally see the Andromeda galaxy with your naked eye. The galaxies born 13 billion years ago aren't any different. They're still bright and optical. So the question is, why do we need an infrared telescope to study these galaxies? And the reason is the expansion of the universe. Light was emitted from these galaxies, and it was mostly visible light, normal, good galaxy, typical galaxy, you know, baby, but still bright, invisible. Then as the light travels from that galaxy to us all the way over here, and it takes that 13 billion years to get here, in that time, the universe has expanded. The universe has stretched out. We were this far away. Here's the baby galaxy that's just forming, and then here's the Milky Way when it gets to us. The light gets to us. We were like this 13 billion years ago, and now we're like this. In that time, space is expanded, and the expansion of space pulls and stretches on electromagnetic waves. It literally makes them longer. It makes them redshifted. And when you crunch through the math of the history of the universe, a galaxy that formed 13 billion years ago and is nice and bright in the optical when it was formed, by the time that light reaches us now, it has stretched into the no prizes awarded for guessing correctly infrared. That's right. James Webb will take pictures of some of the first galaxies to ever appear, which, guess what? We don't have pictures of. That's pretty cool because we need a major giant infrared observatory, and James is going to be exactly that. Another thing James Webb is going to go after are baby solar systems and protoplanetary disks. All these, it's so cute. Like, to make a solar system, make a star, you need a lot of gas and dust. But you need that gas and dust to be crunched down into a very small volume. And to crunch something down into a really small volume, you need it to be cold. Because if it's hot, it'll just stay hot and out here. But as you cool it and cool it and cool it and cool it, that's what allows it to compress and start forming stars. And then around those stars, planets can start forming. It's a colder thing. It's not emitting invisible light anymore. It's going to emit in the infrared. So we'll get pictures of baby solar systems. And another thing we're going to get pictures of are planets themselves. On board the James Webb, on its cameras, are going to be little devices called coronagraphs, which are designed to block out the light from a star. Like, literally just like, okay, I've blocked out the star. Now I can see something by it. Oh, look at that. I can see the light from a planet. And guess what? Planets emit in infrared radiation. The Earth is warm. It's glowing in infrared like crazy. So we'll be able to blot out stars and look directly and take pictures of planets around it. We can do this from the ground. It's really, really challenging. James is going to be awesome at this. And remember how I said in the last video, and if you don't remember, you should watch the last video talking about the instrumentation of James Webb and why we're putting it in space. Our atmosphere has things like water, carbon dioxide, methane that block infrared light, which sucks for astronomy on the ground. But if you're taking a picture of a distant exoplanet, a planet around another star, and you're seeing certain wavelengths of infrared light missing, then you know light emitted from that planet, from the surface of the planet, filtered through its atmosphere, is blocking some of the radiation, which means it has water, carbon dioxide, methane. With the James Webb Space Telescope, we'll be able to study atmospheres of exoplanets, hunting for signs of life. Don't know if we'll find life. James Webb isn't going to be able to do this for a lot of planets because, you know, it has to pinpoint one at a time. So it's not a major survey like Kepler or TESS is, but Kepler archives and TESS are going to find some promising candidates and say, hey, James, go check out this one. I think you'll like what you'll see. And James will look at it, blot out a star, look at exoplanet, and say, ooh, I do like what I see. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed. Please go to patreon.com/PM Sutter to keep all this business going. I really do appreciate it. It's all my science education outreach activities are funded by Patreon. Patreon.com/PM Sutter. Please like, share, and subscribe, and watch some more videos. Do whatever you want. And, you know, maybe. In a year and a half, James Webb Space Telescope will actually launch. Please. please, just please.